car design often starts from one aspect, one view. And actually, the first sketch of this car, which was from a low rear three-quarter view, we figured, given its power, given its pedigree, this is going to be the view most often seen by our competitors. This car grew out of a very special environment, set of circumstances. The designers not only designed the product, they designed the process and even the facility in which the car was born. And when all that's done right, that juice, that energy, those genetics go into the product itself. Oftentimes when we begin a project, we will look at what our competition is doing. We scanned the market, and we saw a lot of very capable, well-resolved machines about which we had no feeling. The needle didn't move, We didn't want them. There was no want factor. We didn't want this thing to have a windshield that touches down just behind the headlamps and went all the way to the rear of the car, what we call in the industry a one-box shape. This was a tight cockpit sitting on hefty shoulders being driven by powerful wheel-oriented forms. The previous Maxima had easily the best V6 engine in America, so the engineers had their work cut out for them. But they came through, they delivered, big time. The new Maxima has 32 more horsepower for a total of 222. It's one of those things where you'd ask, how'd they do that? Whoa. One of the traditional problems with sedans is that they look like one thing on the outside, and you get inside and say, oh, what a disappointment. I expected something else. The way we integrated the product was by integrating the process. We invited the interior designers to come up with ideas for the exterior designers to work with the interior. We don't sit in our studios isolated. We're out of the studios. We're going around the country. We're meeting people, observing, listening. There was one woman, rather petite, sat far forward, and her elbow kept searching for and missing the armrest. So we developed a unique, movable armrest for the Maxima. It goes up and forward depending on your stature. In this way, the Maxima is a car that adapts to people rather than asking people to adapt to the car. We wanted you to feel like when you got in this car, you were wearing it. So there's a wave console, we call it, a kind of sweeping gesture that comes off the instrument panel, and that's the receptacle for all the knobs, all the control. Each one is discrete, it's differentiated. Whether you're looking at it or not looking at it, you know where everything is and it's in the right place. Customer expectations for state-of-the-art sedans rise every year. People expect a lot. And if you add them up and put them all into one car, It's a pretty impressive achievement, but 90% of the time it's a boring achievement. What you've made is a reliable, you know, well put together appliance on four wheels. And for us, that simply wasn't enough. I believe every product has a soul. A toaster has a soul. Even an orange juice squeezer has a soul. But the biggest soul of all belongs to the automobile. Americans love cars, and we have a passion for making cars that have an awful lot of soul under the skin.